Students, today I am going to explain about the strings in C language. What is a string? A string is a collection of characters. A collection of characters is called as a string. To make a collection of characters or collection of any variables, we are using arrays. So we can say that a string is also a collection of characters and it is represented by using a character array. A string is a collection of characters. So collection of characters are represented by using a group variable is called as an array variable. So a string is a collection of characters which is represented by using a character array. Right? So in string is a one-dimensional array. It is a one-dimensional array which stores the characters sequentially. For example, SAI, three characters. Three characters are stored in continuous memory locations, A of 0, A of 1, A of 2. Like that, the characters are stored into the arrays. So here we can use a one-dimensional array which stores all the characters. And is only one difference is the strings array, the character array is terminated by a null character. Terminated by a null character slash 0. Means A of 0, A of 1, A of 2 and so on at the last character slash 0. For example, Sai, S-A-I. If you want to say SAI, the last character means A of 0 is, A of 1 is A, A of 2 is I, then the fourth character, A of 3, that is slash 0. That means after completion of the string, the character array is terminated by slash 0. This is called string. How to declare a string? The strings are declared as same as a normal array declaration, but that array type is character type. It's same as normal array creation, but only the difference is the data type of the string is always the character array. The data type is always character. The string name size, it is fixed, one dimension array, but this should be character data type. The strings can be declared by using character array. Character string name size. Example, char name of 30. So in that name I can store maximum of 30 characters length. Maximum of 30 characters length. Right? Take another example, string 1, string 2. One string is having length equals 20 characters, another one is having 40 characters. Right? The format are composting for percentile. Yes, we already discussed in the data types. Percentile S is for the strings. Percentile C for characters. But here we have group of characters. So, percentile S is a control or format string for the strings in C language. Now, what is the structure of the string? So, just now I explained you the character array terminated by null character. And always we are representing the size. If you are taking size equals to 30, the starting index is 0, starts from n minus 1. N minus 1. Right? Now, here by default slash 0 is supplied, is having, then the total number of characters or the length of the string is, for example, SAI 3, but the length becomes 4. Because we are adding slash 0. Means if you are declaring name of 4 here, we can represent only Sai. We can't more than that. We can't store SSDC into name of 4. Why? The last character is for null character. So this is a array. Now consider character name of 7. Means it is accepting how many characters? 7 characters. T, E, C, H, N, O. How many characters are there? 6 characters. We can't use S, take notes. Take no one. Why? The last character should be null character. See the representation. T-E-S-H. T-E-C-H-N-O slash 0. So the original length of the string plus 1. That is called the structure of the string. Now, then we can go for the how to initialize. Here we are discussing about the declaration. So after declaration, I want to give some value. Int a, a equals to 10, character array using for loops. Now here we can use initialization formula two ways, by using assignment operator and by using scanf. If you are using by using assignment operator, character name of 6 equals to a, b, c, d, e. It means name of 6 characters a, b, c, d, e. Omega you are giving 5, the 6th one is slash 0. That is character array name of size equals to, like this. We can use individual character, we can use group characters. Right? This is called assignment operator. Then using scanf, if you are using scanf, percentile s name. Right? You can use, this is the static initialization. This is also static initialization, single character, single quotation. Group of characters, double quotations. Means double quotation is available, it is called as a string. Okay, percentile is name. It will take only one word. It will not entire line. Right? This is the above format allows to accept any only string which does not have any blank spaces, tab, new line, anything. And for example, I am giving that welcome to C programming. Welcome space 2. The space will not be taken by percentile s. It will take only welcome. Welcome to strings. Program for strings. Program only taken. For will not be taken. Why? Space is available between program and for. For example, this example, the carriage return. So it is accepting only carriage. It will not take return value. Right? The above format I am giving. Only the will be taken by this. It will not take above format. Why? The string will accepting that only up to space. Right? This is about the scanf. Okay. Then displaying. This is nothing but accessing the string. How to display? Printf. Printf you are using means you can use percentile. Yes. Or you can also use puts function. Gets also you can use here. Puts. Gets we are using up to here to here. New line. Here gets and puts also we can use as a reading and writing strings. Gets, puts. Gets of name, puts of name. Gets of name means the entire will be taken. Right? Scanf means only one word will be taken. This is the difference between strings. Okay? Then string handling. How we can handling the strings? How we can handle the string? For example, a plus b, two integers, is easily arithmetic operation and so on. But I want to handle some string handling functions, string functions. I want to check that it is a lowercase letter, it is uppercase letter, it is what is the length of the string, how many characters are available in this. Like that, I want to perform some operations on string. That is then we can have the string handling function. Strings are used in string handling operations such as counting the length of the string, concatenating string, copying one string to another string, comparing two strings, converting the lowercase string to uppercase string, and uppercase to lowercase, reversing. These are the several functions we have in string handling. We can find out the length of the string, we can concatenate two strings into one string, we can copy from string to another string, comparing both are equal or not, lowercase to uppercase to lowercase. These functions we can achieve by using functions. First one, strlen. String length function is used to find out the number of characters in the given string. How many characters are there in the given string is identified by from the strlen function. Strlen of string. Example, strlen of college. How many characters are there? 7. It does not display 8, only 7. Slash is taken as a null character. Right? Length will be 7. String concatenation. I want to combine two strings into two strings. Then we can use strcat. This function is used to combine two strings into a single string. Here, what is the syntax of this? Strcat string 1 comma string 2. Here, don't think that string 1 is comparing to string 2. This string is added to here. This string is adding to this string. String concatenation string 1 comma string 2. The second string can be appended to first string. Okay. Just see the example. Start college degree. Right? Degree college. College is adding to degree. Right? It's college degree. Means degree college. Then string comparison. This function compares two strings and returns 0 if the string 1 is same as string 2. How it is verified? By using ASCII characters again. ASCII code of C, ASCII code of D. Both will be subtracted. We are getting one negative number or positive number. C minus E. We are getting one number. So every character in the in your C language, we have an ASCII number. Based on this ASCII number, it will be copying. Return 0, both are equal. Return less than 0 if string 1 is less than string 2. Greater than 0 if string 1 is greater than str2. Now consider the example. SCI, SCA. S is small letter, A is small letter, I is small letter. S is small letter, A is small letter, I is small. Both are equal now. S minus S, ASCII number minus ASCII number 0. A minus A, 0. I minus I, 0. Total equals to 0. Means return 0, equal. Now consider. S, capital S, A, I. Small S, small A, small I. Capital S, ASCII number is less than 2, small s. Right, then minus number. Capital A minus number, minus, minus plus minus plus minus, again minus, so not equal, less than 0. Next, here, greater than 0. Now consider capital A, it is 96, small a 65, subtract, we are getting one positive number. So this is called as a not equal. This is about the string comparison. Then string copy, copying from one string to another string. The string function is used to copy one string to another string, which copies the second string to first string. Second string to first string. Right? Now check it. Example. str1 SIVA, str2 is Sivashivani. Now str1, str2. Means this string is copied to this one. Means SIVA is replacing with now Sivashivani. Okay? This one is replacing with this one. Right? This is called str2 is replacing by replacing with str1 is replaced by str2. This is a string copy. Then n copy. N copy means number of characters. I want to copy from SIVA to S2VA. SIVA I want to copy. Then you can go for str n copy. This function copies the number of characters to another string. Here you can specify the number of characters. String 1, string 2 same. Here n copy is there. N, there is no n. Right? Then number of characters. Just consider the example strabc, str2, sscn. Now I want to replace siva into str1. str1 comma str2 means this one will be copied to this. But how many characters? Only 4 characters. siva will be copied to str1. Now str1 is siva. This is strcpy. Next, str lower, string lowercase. Converting the string to lowercase. This function is used to convert the given string into lowercase format. Right, siram, siram. Now I want to uppercase. The function is used to convert to lowercase to uppercase. Right, siram. Then reverse. So it will be reversed. String will be rev means reversing the string. So automatically it reverse the strings. Strav. Then abcd I'm giving dcea. So these are the several functions of the string. Now go for the string function. Program. Program for strings. Now here I am explaining only some functions. I am declaring string 1, string 2, string 3. Right? Now I am entering string 1 and string 2. How many enter? I mean 2 entering. Right? Just I enter 2 strings. Printf, printf. Right? Then after this I am finding the lengths. Right? Then see the output. There is no output is given. Now consider that. For example, I given SIVA here. The SIVA is 4. SIVA will be displayed. String 2, Shivani, SIVA, NI. Right? 4, 6. Copy. String 3. Means string 2 is copied to string 3. What is string 2? Shivani. Shivani is copied to string 3. Next, string concatenation. String 3 is compared, concatenator string one. SIVA, this is one SIVANI. Shiva Shivani is come. After concatenation, Shiva Shivani will be displayed. Right? Then another program for strings. Same. You also use getS function. I enter my name, Sai, SAI in the small letters, it will be again small letters. If I enter the capital letters, it will be converted to capital letters. Again, lower letters to uppercase. Reverse. ABCD I am giving, DCBA will be displayed. Length of the string. This is about the string functions and string manipulations in the C programming language.